Alrighty, so let's start by sitting tall. Feel the feet grounding into the floor and spine lengthening through the crown of the head. And take some slow, mindful breaths in and out through the nose. Feel the ribs, the lower ribs especially expanding with that nice deep breath. And maybe notice the little pause between the inhale and exhale, and after you exhale, maybe dwell there for a second or two. Just a little pause just before you exhale. And then before you inhale.
Petra, you're crackling. Your voice is crackling.
Don't know what's going on. Let's see. Yeah, I am connected to my AirPods, so.
So I hear you, Michelle, is crackling, and I don't hear you, Petra, is crackling.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
So I don't
Yeah.
know.
Sorry, Michelle. Maybe it's on your side. I don't know. Hopefully you can understand me. I'll try to speak loud.
Much better now.
Okay, good. Right, where were we? Breathing. Breathing and then pausing after the inhale. Good. And then opening your eyes. Wide, big eyes. Open your eyes wide. Like a surprise. Open, open, open. And then big smile. That's it. And we'll do ooh. So sort of like a sound, so sounding ooh, and then e, ooh, 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 e. Good. Nice. And then let's do and then then let's do some shoulder circles. Good. And maybe let's do the breath of joy again. Did we do it last time? Just like a way to wake up. Let's see, I have to remember. So it's, yeah. So you're inhaling in three parts. So first, arms go forward, then out to the side, then the last part of the in breath, and then you go, ha! Okay, so it's through the nose. Ha. So you're right, three times the inhale is in three parts and then one big exhale. Ha. Okay, so it's kind of stimulating and gets rid of some extra stuck energy. So ha. Forward, side, up, in ha. Ha. One more. Good. And I just pause and feel. I always feel the energy a little bit up. Yeah, it's a good one when you feel angry or frustrated. It's just like getting rid of that energy. All right, let's reach up if you can without, you know, too much pain. So we're picking that apple. Other side. Hi, Greg. We don't see you yet. Oh, sorry. Up and up. Good. And then we'll do reach through one hand, but just forward. So you're leaning forward and reaching. And there you are. Hi. Reach and reach and reach. All right. And then we'll reach to the side. Reach and reach and reach and reach. Oh, is somebody unmuted? No. Okay. Reach and reach and reach. Good. And then we'll reach across. So reach across the body. Reach. All right. Nice job. Keep breathing. Very good. All right. And then we'll reach with both arms back. So kind of like you're putting the elbow, pushing the elbows back, and then straightening the arms. And push those elbows back and straighten and open the palms. And push back. And push back, back behind you. Good. Keep your chest up. And push back. And push back. Awesome. Good. And then relax your arms. And we'll do just a little bit for the fingers. So keep your fingers straight and then open, close, open, close. Hi, Helen. Good. And then make a fist and open. Two, three, four, really wide. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Great. And then we're going to touch the thumb towards the root of the pinky and then towards the, ooh, it might be hard. The root might be hard. So let's do the top of the finger. So pinky, ring finger, middle finger, index. And then do it a few times. Thumb to all of these fingers. Nice job. Great. And then we're going to straighten that arm and pull on the finger, stretch the forearm and the fingers. Now relax the shoulders away from your ears. Just, yeah, good. And then we'll point those fingers down. So point those fingers down and stretch. You could stretch slightly this way towards you. So you're stretching the top of the forearm. Great. And then release. And then we'll do the other arm. So first fingers up. Stretch, stretch, stretch. Keep breathing. Good. And then point those fingers down, and then maybe slight stretch with the other hand. Fingers down, so palm is facing you. Good. All right, and then release. And then let's do circles of the wrists. Nice. Good, and then we'll do little wings and we'll do circles with those elbows. Reach back. Nice work. All right. And then let's bring the whole arm. So straight arm back. So circles, basically circles next to you. With one arm, bringing it back and up and forward and down. Good, and then we'll try the other side. And you know, you can modify the range of motion, Michelle, so it doesn't hurt too much, okay? Awesome. Good. And then we'll do sort of like a bicep curl. So elbows are in and you're just hinging at those elbows. So up and straighten fully. Bend and straighten. Nice. Good. And then we'll do this stretch. So bringing the hands behind you, behind your neck or head or wherever you can reach. And so elbows point up and you're stretching the back of the arm, the triceps. If you want even more stretch, you could do that. You know, one hand grabs that elbow and brings it closer. To point even more up. Keep breathing. Great. And other side if you're doing one. Good, and release. All right. Let's do cat and cow, so rounding a little bit between the shoulder blades on the exhale. And then shoulders go back, chest lifts. You're sort of projecting the heart forward. And exhale, and inhale. All right. Okay, so let's do you guys all have a stretch? You could for some of the exercises you could do a yoga strap too. Although Although I want to try to bind the legs after, and for that one, you kind of need a resistance band. But let's first put it around the left foot, and we'll do this, the push and bend and straighten against that strap 10 times on each side. So one, yeah, let's wait for everyone to get one. Did you find one, Michelle Johnston? Oh, great. Okay. So one and two and three. Try to really straighten that knee. Four and five and six and seven and eight and nine and 10. Actually, let's keep it on the side and just take a little break. Maybe we'll do one more set. You know, with the strength training, we kind of have to up the volume so we see some benefits. So one set is usually not enough. So 2 to 3 is better. So let's do one more 10. So 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 5 and 6 and 7 and 8 and 9 and 10. All right, great. Yeah, you could do this even when you're like watching TV or something. Strengthening your legs. All right, and then still on the same side, and we'll do a circle with a straight leg. So 1, 2, core engaged, sitting tall, 3, 4, 5. And then reverse, go the other direction, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Nice work. Good. So you should feel the thigh muscles a little bit. I do. Okay. And then let's do out to the side, just this way. So 1 and just tapping out, 2 and 3 and 4 and 5 and 6. And 7 and 8 and 9 and 10. Awesome. All right, then we can switch. Hi, Sally there. We don't see you, but see your name written on the black screen. Okay, oh, there you are. All right, so we'll do the 2 sets of 10 with a little break in between. So nice straight leg, 2 and 3 and 4 and 5 and 6 and 7 and 8 and 9 and 10. All right, take a little break. We'll do, you know, the break between the sets should be about 30 seconds to a minute. So, you know, a little longer than you'd think, just so the muscles can reload on the energy, on the fuel. And then let's do another one. So hold that strap maybe a little lower because your legs are strong, so you can work with more resistance. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Awesome. Okay. Yeah, I think these exercises are great, especially if you don't get to walk a lot. You know, maybe you're injured or you have too much fatigue. So that way you can still keep your legs strong. All right, and then we'll go up and down with straight legs. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Awesome. And then one more exercise after a little break while we're going out to the side. So we'll go 1 and 2. And 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Awesome. Great. And so then you can take it off, and then we'll put the strap over your thighs. So thighs are together, knees together, feet together. You're gonna put it on top, and then you're gonna cross it under your legs and then pull up on the straps. And so your legs are tight together. Yeah, you don't have to even do a knot. You can just hold on, pull up on those ends. And then so this is suddenly gonna feel harder, right, to bring the knees apart. So we're gonna try to open the knees, kind of like you're doing a clamshell on the side. So opening the knees to the side against that resistance. So this purple one is pretty strong, so it's gonna feel pretty hard. Michelle, you have one, right? You have this one. So just push out against that resistance. Good. And then take a little break. Ooh, I can feel it here. And then we'll try stepping out. And so again, this time we're again working or targeting these muscles here. So what you don't want to do is this, right? Where the knee stays in and you're just sending out the foot, because we're working this whole side. So we're gonna try to step out with that knee, even if it's just a little bit, but the knee is leading, not the foot. Foot is under the knee. So side and side, side, side. Great, keep breathing, especially if it feels hard. The breathing is important. And you know, this gluteus medius, the muscle on the side, is really important for balance, for gait. It's a really important muscle. Good. And take a little break. You can knock the knees together so you can release that side of the hip. Take a few breaths. And then we'll do one more. Maybe I'm gonna make it just a little bit looser because I had it really tight. And then we're gonna try to hop both apart and together. Okay, so that's the last one for the hips. Then we can rest the hips. So open and close, and open and close. So your core comes into the play too. Open and close, open and close. Good. Nice job. Good. All right. And then you can get rid of the strap. And so let's stretch the side of the hip. So we'll try to bring the knees together again. And then without moving your upper body, you're moving the knee, both knees to the right until you feel a nice stretch here on the left side. So you can even use your hand to push your knees slightly to the right. And we could add a little twist. So you can turn the shoulders towards the left. So keep pushing those knees to the right and twisting to the left. And breathing. Good. Very good. And then back to center, and we'll do the other side. So push your knees over to the left. And then find that length in the spine and twist to the right. Great. And then back to center. And then we'll hug the right knee in, do some more ankle circles. And reverse. Good. And then if you can, place that ankle on top of your thigh. And if that's a little too much, you can go a little lower, so straightening this leg, maybe staying here, or even supported by the floor. But here you probably get the deepest stretch if you can get it up. And then finding nice length in the spine again. If you don't feel much, if your hips are maybe pretty open, you could even lean forward a little bit towards the thighs. But for most people, even sitting up straight is good. And actually not easy to sit up straight here for a lot of people, because the tendency is to sort of round like this, right? If you have tight hips and the pelvis sort of tilts under, and you are trying to find that natural arch here, that lift. Good. And then slowly release. Then we'll do the whole thing on the other side. So first, just hug your knee in, hug your shin in, do those ankle circles. Keep the breath flowing while you do that. And reverse. Awesome. And then if you can, put that ankle on top. And then again, finding that length in the spine. Taking nice long breaths through your nose. And creating that nice natural arch in the low back. Awesome. Maybe even leaning forward a bit if you want more sensation in the hip. Great. And then release. And then we'll take a forward fold. So you can slightly open the knees to make space for your body, and then go down your legs wherever you can reach. Maybe you can go all the way down or just staying halfway up. Take a few breaths here. Good, and then on the next inhale, coming up, back into sitting. All right. Okay, should we do a little bit of music? A little bit of moving with music before we go down. I mean, not down, but slow down. Okay, let's see. All right, let's start with rocking with those feet, heels and toes. Nice, and then let's reach to the side. Good. And then let's reach across again. You okay, Greg? Oh. Good. Nice. And then just march. And then flick your fingers open while you march. Good, and sideways. Good, and up. All right, and we're gonna go side to side until you can even out. Maybe lift one sit bone off the chair. That's it, nice. Good, and then kick, kick, kick. Nice big kick. Stepping side to side, sideways. Good. And then We can move the arms opposite direction. Waste time with the masterpiece, to waste time with the masterpiece. You should be rolling with me, you should be rolling with me. You will be a life fantasy, you will be a life fantasy. Nice. And then we're gonna go open everything out and together. Nice big scar. That's it. Beautiful. Nice. Okay. And then we're going to go opposite knee touch. Left. Good. And then we're gonna go into a clap. So clap to the side. Good. And a little higher up. Oh, good. And then you're gonna sort of push, 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 push. All right. Good, and then let's just lift one shoulder up and down the other. Good, and try both at the same time. So lift and release. Lift, release. Good, and then keep them released. And then let's put one forward and then the other. So a little rotating side to side. Good. Nice. Yeah, and big wave. At the end of my playlist. Oh no. Okay. We have some more. Okay. And then we're gonna interlace fingers and you're gonna draw infinity sign. And reverse, go the other direction. It's better to never ask why. That's it, beautiful. All right, and then we're gonna go up and down on the side. So up to the right, down to the left for now. And then other side, so up to the left, down to the right. Nice. All right. And then relax the shoulders and arms. Just tap at the feet. with the rhythm, lifting those toes up high. And then heel out, heel in, heel both. In, out, in, out. Good. Nice. And walk again. Up, keep breathing. Good. And then let's reach forward. Let's do that nice power up. Open the fingers as you reach back. That's it. Nice. Okay. And then we're gonna sort of scoot back. So you're scooting back into your chair and then forward. And scooting back. Hopefully you have a slidey chair, a little harder if it's, but you can still do it. So basically shifting your weight onto one side, right, onto one shin bone, and then you can move that hip forward or back. So it's shifting weight is the basis of this movement. Good. Nice. Okay, and then I've been trying it in this week in my classes. Let's try. I'm gonna turn up the music, and it's a sort of it's a sort of coordination exercise. First, I was totally struggling with it, so don't be surprised if you can't quite get it. It takes some practice, so. We're gonna basically do something different with each hand. So the left hand will just be going up and down like this, up and down, right? And then the right hand will go up and then side and down. And then the trick is to do both at the same time. So we're gonna go, I'll go really slow. So now I sort of remember that pattern. So it's gonna be easier for me than for you, but both go up, right? And then the left one goes down and the right one goes to the side. And then they follow their path. So the left one goes up because it's just going up and down, but this one goes down because it has to finish. And then the right one goes up, left one goes down, and then side on the right, up on the left. And then they both meet going down. And then we go again, both go up. And then left goes down, right goes to the side. And then they split again. And then they split again the other way. And right goes to the side. And then both to the floor, towards the floor and up. All right, so I had to sort of like close my eyes and really focus on what I'm doing. So you can take the time. It's just a good workout for the brain. So try again. Left goes up and down. How are you doing? Both down and then both up. Yeah, so you can practice. It took me a while. And then you can add like walking to it and making it a little harder. And then I have one more coordination that I've been doing with the classes this week. So I'll show you some arrows. So I'll be kind of standing closer. So can you guys see where the arrow is pointing pretty well? Okay. So there's either green or red. And so if I show you the red, you're gonna do the opposite direction. Okay. So if it's red color, you're gonna go to the opposite direction. So this one is pointing to your left. So you would step out. You would from that chair, you would step out to the right. Okay. So if I show you this, so that goes down. Down means going, oh shoot, how are we gonna go back in the chair? So I guess you could just you're just hiding your feet under. I mean sort of like stepping back, right? But because this is red, it means the opposite. So instead of going back, you're gonna go forward. So you're gonna sort of lengthen your feet forward. And then what do we have? So this is green going to the left. So you would just go to the left because it's green. So this is pointing up, which normally you would go forward, but because it's red, you need to go do the opposite. So and it goes like that. Okay, so let's try it. So you just take that moment to think about what you're doing. And we're sort of practicing this multitasking, moving and thinking, and also that stop and go, sort of that inhibition. Like, oh, I want to go there, but actually I need to go to the other side. So it's a good practice for the brain. So where would you go? Yeah, you could do it with the arms too. Yeah, we could do it with the arms. So you could do up instead of using the legs. So you could do up. So this would be up, and down would be down. So this is green, so you go up. Yes. So yeah, you're ex exactly. You're doing the opposite. So instead of going to the left, you go to the right. So it's green and going down. Yeah, so you go down. Exactly, doing the opposite. That's it. Nice. Going up because it's green, it's red. That's it. So going down with the hands, yes, or feet. Nice. Hey, you guys are getting it. Exactly, the opposite. Nice. Good. And then I'm gonna make it a little harder. So instead of doing the opposite, if you see the red color, you're still gonna do the same direction that it shows, but you're gonna say the opposite. So instead of doing the opposite, you're gonna say the opposite, okay? So if it's green, you go down and you say down. But if it's red, you point to the left but say right. Say the opposite instead of doing the opposite, okay? No, you're not getting it, Michelle. You don't see it? Okay, I'll try to be closer. It has a little bit of a glare, I know. Okay, so this points down. So you do the same. I know before we did the opposite, but now you do the same. You point down, but you say up. So you say the opposite. Okay. So yeah, you point to the left and you say left. You do the same. Do the same as the edit point, but say the opposite. Good. So up again and say up. Good. Yeah, so you do the up, do the same, but say right. Good. Now you'd say down and point down. Yeah, exactly. And you say right. Uh-huh. You do the same right now and say the opposite. Yeah, so go down with the hands and say up. Good, that's it. And let's do this one. Point up and you say down. Good. Good, that's it. All right, one more maybe. Yeah, so you say right. Mm-hmm. Good. Okay, great job. Just a little bit for the brain. All right, so let's come back to the chair. Let's take another forward fold. Relax your back, relax your shoulders and neck. And then lifting back up. And then bring your knees apart and we'll do that side bend. So either on your forearm or hand, hold that side bend. And then back up, another side. And back together, back to center. And then we're gonna bring the arms into cactus. And then you're gonna squeeze elbows towards each other and inhale, open. And exhale. And inhale. And a few more times like that. Nice big inhale as you open the chest. Awesome. One last time. And then relax the arms. Good. And then we'll just take, maybe let's take six really slow, mindful breaths. So closing your eyes and pretend you're smelling something nice. So you're slowly getting that smell into your nose. Nice long inhale and a nice slow long exhale. Great. And then just settle into your chair and then relax your body. And then let's try to become aware of the right side of your body, as if you were sort of inhaling into the right side of your body. Become aware of it. Whole right side, including your legs, I mean, right leg, right arm. Right face, right side of the face. And then switch to the left side. So left leg, left side of the pelvis, left side of the trunk, and face. And then bring awareness to the back side of your body. So your the backs of your legs, the buttocks, low back and upper back, and the back of your head and neck. And then the front side of the body. And then become aware of your whole body. Awesome. And slowly opening your eyes and stretching. Awesome. And then we'll close the class. Our little setting of an intention. And you could have your own sentences that you set an intention for. But you can also repeat after me in your mind. May I be happy. May I be healthy. May I be mindful. May I have courage. And may I treat myself and others with love and compassion. And then hands to your forehead as a reminder of the power of your thoughts. Hands to your lips as a reminder of the power of your words. And hands to your heart as a reminder of the power of your actions. Thanks, everyone. Great work. So you can work on your arm exercise. we can try next time again. It does take a while. Yeah, first I was totally struggling, now because I taught it on Monday and this morning, so now I'm getting better at it. All right, see you guys soon. Have a good one. Bye.